anything 2020 has taught me is that my mental health is very important. I mean, yeah, 2020 was a big year. I got married. That was like a big yes for me. At the same time, I said a big no in 2020. So, if there's anything I learned, is that I need to take care of my mental health. And that true friendship is very important. Like, it's good to have good friends around. Hey guys, welcome to TY Vlogs. My name is Omotayo and I film about faith, marriage, lifestyle and relationship from Lagos, Nigeria. Guys, thank you so much for the show of love. I'm really grateful. Thank you for the messages. Thank you for liking. Thank you for the encouragement. Thank you for the good words and kind words. Thank you for commenting. I'm so grateful for comments. I really appreciate them. And thank you so much for subscribing. The ones that subscribe, I'm so grateful. The ones that have not subscribed, please subscribe. See, if you're actually just joining, you're welcome. Like, if you're just joining, you're welcome. I'm a new YouTuber and please stay tuned. It promised to be very interesting. I promise. Actually, there's a red button. I don't know if it's this side or the other side, but it's just there on your phone looking at you right now. They wrote subscribe on it. Please just click it or smash it. Please subscribe, guys. Thank you so much. I'm really grateful. There's actually a lot of things that's taught us, even about ourselves, friendship, relationship, our passions, values, a whole lot of things, personal growth, learning opportunities. I'm sure that it has actually taught you a whole lot of stuff. Number one, take that leap of faith. Like, if there's anything 2020 has taught me, is to take that leap of faith. Just do it. Like, if there's anything you want to put your mind, like, that you want to do, you set your mind on it that, oh, this is what I wish to do, or there is something that you really want to do. I'm not there yet, right? But if there's anything I've taken out of 2020, is for you to just put it into work, put your faith into action. Whatever you want God to do for you, whatever you want to do for yourself, just do it. Do it with faith. I mean, among other stuff, an example is starting this YouTube channel. I've been wanting to do it for the longest time, right? But I uploaded it on December 31st because I'm like, I must upload it. I'll just do it. I won't wait for the following year. I won't wait for January 1st. I want to upload it in December 31st. I just did it like that. Fine. It's not like I was not scared or whatever, but I just took that step of faith. So if there's anything 2020 has taught me, that would also love to imbibe, like, inculcate for the rest of the years. I mean, rather than waiting for life to just pass us by, I mean, wasting time, it's just better to act. Just do that thing. Second point is finding joy in simple things. More like saying, be grateful regardless of whatever. Be grateful to God for where you are, where you've been, where you are going, whatever you are doing right now. It might not look like it yet. Only my jive, but all in all, giving all the glory to God, finding joy in whatever situation. It might seem like, what's going on at some point? Do you understand? But then, at the end of the day, if there's anything I've learned, is to find joy in even simple things. To find joy in any situation I find myself. Find joy in it. I mean, there's no greater thing than that will come. There's no good thing that will come from being depressed or feeling bad or having negativity. Find joy in whatever you do. Find joy in simple things. Be grateful to God. Be grateful for everything. The third point is action matter more than words. Dreaming is different from doing. Seeing something nice is different from actually showing up and being there for people, your friends or families. My point is, we're a byproduct of our actions, not our goals. We can set goals. If we don't put them into action, nothing is going to come out of it. So if there's anything I learned from 2020, is that action is better than words. The fourth lesson is, difficult times reveal the truth. It's funny how difficult times sometimes actually reveal the real truth about situations, circumstances, or people around you. It could be positive, it could be negative. Fifth point is follow your passions first. Okay, I can also put it like follow your heart first. I mean, the year 2020 has taught us that life doesn't wait for anybody. So why waste time doing something we are not even passionate about? Okay, I know the answer is because of money, right? But if you can't quit your job or change career tomorrow, then find joy and actually make time for hobbies that you are passionate about. It could be anything. It could be like you want to start up a business. It could be taking training. It could be anything. Just follow your heart first. Like, it's very important to like follow the leading of the Holy Spirit. It's very important to like hear yourself out. Some of us, the jobs we are doing, like, we're not even passionate about it, but that motivation is the money that comes at the end of the month, you know. But far above that, when you follow your heart in doing something, like, there's just this like fulfilling, even if it's an hobby, there's just this refreshing experience. It's just like kind of comforting. That's the way I feel about it. So follow your heart, follow your passion first. Six, slow down. Breathe in, breathe out. Sincerely, I don't know if it's just me, but I feel like 2020 actually showed us how much time we can have. Like the shutting down or the lockdown for weeks or months, it kind of give us a free period, like leisure time to be creative, you know, to be able to also like relax. You know, a whole lot of us throughout the year is more like juggling, hustling, bustling. We go to work, we don't even have time for self-reflection or evaluation. We don't even have time for ourselves. But if there's anything I learned in 2020, is the fact that we can actually have time for ourselves. I mean, talk about the funny TikTok videos that was going. A lot of people were just doing funny things. People were so creative during that period. I mean, it's an eye-opener. It opened a whole lot of things in people. Some people, the baby out of them came out. It was just fun. So it taught me that there can actually be time for things like that. It's always a silver lining. Loss of job can actually become an opportunity to turn that side project into a full-time hustle. Or the time that schools were closed and offices were closed, or people get to like work remotely, it could actually be like a time to spend with your kids, families, you know, and even like being at home more. It also like a time to take care of your health. If there's anything I learned in 2020, is be you. Do you unapologetically? Let me say it again. Be you. Do you unapologetically? For real, because you can't satisfy everybody. If there's anything I learned in 2020, you cannot satisfy everybody. You know, there's this saying that whatever you want to do, you can do it. It's actually true. Whatever you want to do, you can do it. The only limit is you. You are the only limit, just like you are the only limit. Now, do not subscribe to my channel. I mean, you can subscribe to my channel if you want to, but the only limit is that you're not subscribing. Please guys, subscribe to my channel. Thank you. The only key thing is that you can't be everything. Yes, you can't be everything, but whatever you want to do, whatever you choose to do or be, let it be your choice. It should not be because your parents said, or your friend said, or your partner or families. It shouldn't be like influence from anywhere. Let it be your choice. If there's influence from anywhere, it should just be like an addition, but not like you're doing things to please people. You're not actually being yourself. It will not help anybody. If there's anything I've learned, is to be myself. Number nine, which was what I said at the beginning. Guys, I learned that my mental health is a priority. You know, 2020 has taught me so much that my mental health is very important. All those people that used to face depression, that used to, you know, it starts from somewhere. It's not just something that just wake up and then they feel like they want to end their life or something. Something triggered it. Like it's probably like a compounded issues for a whole lot of times. And one thing I learned is that there's nobody that can, as in, you're the only one that can take care of your mental health. Whatever you're feeling at that point, nobody is feeling it like you are feeling it. So why not try as much as possible to put everything in place to take care of your mental health. The truth is, we feel like physical health is more important than mental health. Like, I feel like mental health is underrated. I mean, you can't tell an African parent that I'm feeling depressed or I'm feeling overwhelmed. They're like, but if you say, oh, I'm having a headache or malaria, we can resonate with you, we can really help you. Do you get, like, it's physical, so it's something that you can see and can say, oh, sorry, or this. But mental health is something that sometimes you can't just explain. Like, is emotional yet psychological. It has to do with the mental. But seriously, guys, if there's anything, I don't know how best to explain it, but please, if you can relate with whatever I'm saying, please drop it in the comment section below. Mental health is very, very important. Number 10, never stop learning. Oh, guys, I'm sure that if you watch my first video, you know, personally, I love learning so, so much. I love learning so much because I feel like if you're not learning, you're dying. I mean, you're just there. You're stagnant. You're not growing. Guys, I love learning so much and I never stop. And I thank God that even in 2020, I still learned more. Like, never stop learning. Like, learning is very important. You know, one of the greatest joys of life is when you learn something, because it's yours. If you learn anything, you learn skills, recipe, new language, culture, trying out new things, anything. If you learn something, I don't know if I'm the only one, but I kind of feel like this joy within me. For example, when I was doing this YouTube stuff, I mean, like, I'm zero, like, or minus zero in technology, anything technology. I'm not technologically inclined like that, but trying out this YouTube has opened my eyes to some things, especially like the editing part of it, which is the most, I mean, that's where the work is. I don't know, Shimbang, yeah. So guys, but then I feel excited after learning it, after so many rigorous exercise. I mean, it takes time, but then the end result of it, you enjoy it, you feel that kind of fulfillment, like, oh my God, I learned something. And to think that is yours alone, it's not something that somebody can come and snatch from you. It's a skill, you can carry it anywhere you go. It's very useful for you, it improves you, it even boosts your self-confidence, and then you can also impact other people's life aside improving your own also. So please, guys, never stop learning. If there's anything I learned that I should not stop learning, because by learning we grow every day. Be consistent, guys. If you check down my description box, consistency is key, and so help me God, that's what I put there. Like, keep doing that thing, keep on doing it. It might take time, but at the end of the day, it pays off. Last but not the least, create something to look forward to. Bonus point, guys, it's okay to make mistakes, but also learn from other people's mistakes. So guys, I come to the end of the video. Thank you for staying to the end. Comment below, drop a comment for me in the comment section. Share comments, please. Let me know what you guys think. Is there anything you can resonate with, the point I listed, the lessons you learned. If I didn't mention it, please let me know, guys. Let's learn together. Thank you so much, and God bless you.